And then I was like, I've been answering some questions. Some of you have been sending me, like always, news here and there. I've been posting, as you know. For some of you that have been, that are interested in what talk, I appreciate it so much. I send you my link. I'm sending you the videos that you want me to send you. I try to respond a lot of people. But as I was doing that stuff, I was eating with my mom. I was having lunch, actually dinner. And all of a sudden, God told me, go live now. Like that. I was like, don't you think that, don't you think, Father, that maybe I should go tomorrow? And he was like, go live now. So, oh my. So, look, I did some workout on my upper body, and then today I did some workout on my lower body, my legs. I almost vomit. And I just did not have the strength to come out. And all of a sudden, I have to. And it's not that I don't have information, because I do have information. But I gotta tell you guys that I just blocked a guy. Many of you saw the guy. He continuously putting the same stuff. From the Bible says that if you bring in the word of God just to glorify myself, I'll go to hell. And nobody's glorifying Benny here. I'm glorifying my Father. I'm glorifying my Savior. But I'm not glorifying myself. I have said all the time that the worst trolls are the Christians, the so-called Christians, the so-called Christians. Because these are the people that it doesn't matter what you do. If you play contemporary music, Christian beautiful contemporary music, inspirational music, you do it wrong for them. If you come to pray, you're doing wrong for them. If you listen to a Catholic like myself, you're doing wrong for them. If you, oh my goodness, it doesn't matter what you do. These people is the worst. They're the worst trolls. I'm telling you right now, the worst trolls. I think I mentioned before when I used to work in a bank that I had to sue somebody because that guy was stalking me. He was actually harassing me. One of those Christians. He was harassing me. And to the point that I had to call human resources on him. And they actually got into, they actually fired the guy. But because the guy was not, he would not stop harassing me at all. There are a lot of big, crazy people out there. So this is the reason why you need to protect your identity. You need to protect your image. You need to protect your personal information. Because you don't know what is out there. And by the way, this show is called War and Peace. We're going to talk about that. And I've told you yesterday that this month, it will be about that. It will be about war and peace. And the elite, the old elite, is pushing for the World War III right now. Right now, they're pushing for the World War III. And how do we know that we close for DRB? Because of prophecy. Because the prophecy says that when things seems at the worst, and I told you many times in many of my shows, the more likely scenarios that we are going to see when we are going to be an RB. Okay? There will be a war. We're going to be in a very bad war. There will be chaos and panic and riots in the United States and around the world. They might even be attacking Israel. We might even have one nuclear bomb come out because three prophets prophesied it after Bill Graham died. So we are right now at the doors of the RB, and every single guru up there have not warned you about that. It doesn't matter if the ISIS come out, you're going to change in 24 hours. It doesn't matter if Daesh come out, you're going to change in about 12 hours. If you go and the whole thing just collapse, the banking collapse, don't worry, you're going to change in 4 hours. And they keep lying and lying and lying and lying again, and you're not changing. So the only one telling you things are not going to be pretty is me. Why? Because no guru is telling you the truth. No guru is preparing you for the best and the worst. No guru is opening your eyes that the only one who is in control of this is Jesus. Nobody else. So, like that troll, that the Christian troll that I block, I have never said, look, Benny's great. Oh, look, Benny's the best. Nope. Oh, look, Benny's taking all the credit. Nope. Never. If we write, and I say we, if we write, is because we are collecting all the evidence from the prophetic word. We are in discernment of the truth. We are looking into the real process of the RB and the real process of the GCR and the real process of the wealth transfer. Not Benny. Only Jesus. I gave Jesus my life. And I gave Jesus all the credit and all the glory. Because we are nothing without God. Nothing. It doesn't matter how filthy rich you're going to become. You are nothing but a miserable rich people if you don't have Jesus Christ in your life. Bottom line. And God told me, go on live right now. He did not tell me why. So I said, my Lord, I will go live right now, my Lord. My body's aching. I have pain all over my body. But if I have to die by glorifying your name, my Lord, I will do it right now. So for those trolls that love to just throwing scripture on you and using it in a really bad way by attacking another Christian, you're not welcome on my page. Bottom line. El show se llama Guerra y Paz, y se llama Guerra y Paz por lo que está sucediendo ahorita. La élite está empujando para que pase la guerra, la tercera guerra mundial, que sería nuclear. Acabo de sacar un idiota llamado Cristiano, que me estaba tirando escrituras de una Biblia, alguna de ustedes lo vio, que decía, ay de aquel que se glorifique de su nombre, para bien de ellos. Y ya me lo había tirado dos veces y lo perdoné la primera vez. Este es el tipo de cristiano que si tú pones música cristiana, tú haces mal. No representa a Cristo, no es un ministerio, no te sirve para nada. Si yo te digo que soy católico, tú haces mal. Porque estás oyendo a una persona que es idólatra. Si tú traes al pueblo de Dios a enfocarse en el reino de Dios, tú haces mal. Porque el reino de Dios no se encuentra en la internet. O sea, no importa lo que tú vayas a hacer, siempre vas a encontrar este tipo de idiota que siempre pretende estar en lo correcto. Yo tuve que demandar legalmente a un idiota de esos cuando yo trabajaba en un banco. Me estaba acosando todos los días, de tal manera que lo echaron del banco. Encima de eso, me empezó a acosar fuera del banco, hasta que lo mandé a la cárcel. Hay mucha gente loca allá afuera, y por eso yo le he dicho a todo el mundo, protege tu identidad. Muchos de ustedes todavía vienen con su fotografía y tu nombre completo. Protege tu identidad, porque aparentemente tú crees que esto no va a pasar. Y aparentemente tú crees que cuando tú te hagas completamente rico o rica, la gente te va a apreciar más. Aparentemente tú crees que no te va a molestar, que nada de eso te va a perjudicar. Pero la verdad es otra. Cuando la gente te creía que tú eres un come mierda, ahora te van a hacer comer mierda. ¿Y cómo? Agarrándote de una manera o de otra. O te van a quitar un pedazo de ti a las buenas, o te lo van a quitar a las malas. Secuestros, extorsiones, etcétera, etcétera. Pero como yo no soy el papi de ustedes, yo no les digo nada. El ser humano va a tener que aprender a las buenas o a las malas. Y lo digo esto en español, porque ya en inglés ya entendieron con solamente dos veces que le he dicho. Ustedes, muchos de los latinos, la gran mayoría, no importa cuántas veces se lo he dicho, no van a hacer caso. Así que, buena suerte. Espérate, vamos a hablar ahora con la pastora McCoy, porque ella tiene una palabra profética que se llama Epifanía, si lo estoy diciendo bien. Te voy a decir cómo dice la palabra profética, tengo que traducirla ahorita, porque no me dio tiempo. Yo no podía salir ahorita, yo no quería salir, pero Dios me dijo sal, y no me dijo por qué. Estoy entrenándome en el gimnasio. Ayer me hice, hace dos días me hice entrenamiento de brazos y ahora hice de las piernas y casi vomito de tanto que estaba haciendo ejercicio. No estaba yendo condiciones para salir aquí ahorita a hacer mi show, pero Dios manda todo, así que yo tengo que hacerle caso a Él. Así que, ¿por qué Dios me dijo que viniera acá? Es porque hay cosas importantes que tengo que compartir con ustedes. Todo sea por la gloria de Él y no por los idiotas que se hacen llamar cristianos que te atacan de una o de otra vez. ¿Ok? Porque yo nunca he tenido, nunca te he dicho, hey, todo el crédito se lo das a Benny. No, nunca. Nunca he querido decirte, el que mejor da Intel es Benny. No. La palabra Intel quiere decir inteligencia. Y el único que tiene la inteligencia y la sabiduría en todo el universo es Dios. Así que yo no pretendo saberlo todo. Yo lo he dicho bien claramente, tanto en inglés como en español. Yo nunca voy a dar una opinión si no sé de qué estoy hablando. Yo no soy un retardado. Parecería yo un retardado, pero no lo soy. Así que espérate. All right, so we're going to call my Pastor McCoy, and I want to tell you something. Today, we have an intel. We have intel today. After the intel, the intel I'm going to give it to you by before the end of the show, okay? So be patient. So hold on, let me call my Pastor McCoy. And we're going to talk about the prophetic word, Epiphany. So hold on. I'm going to call my pastor. Hold on. Epiphany. Hold on. It's just not answering. Oh, she finally answering. All right.
Hello.
Hello.
I hear you're in pain.
Yes, I am.
That's funny.
Yes, I am. You know, I had to pay this trainer, right? And And I had to do it, you know, because I'm diabetic, so I need to be really working out.
Yeah,
Fortunately, my lifestyle is only being in a desk, in the computer, lifestyle. I do my work from home, okay? So I got to be stuck 12, 18 hours in a computer. So I really don't have any exercise to do. The little exercise I do is when I go to the market. I walk. I don't take my car. I don't have a car. I can still buy Uber. I can still call Uber. But I don't do exercise. Start bugging me now that, you know, that I'm gaining weight. That's, you know, I look like a pregnant Latino. So, you know, it's like, oh my goodness. And my girls now like looking at me like, oh, like, yeah, you know. So I have to like, okay. Let me take some measures, you know. I signed a contract, and I feel good. Other than that, I'm dying. I feel good.
Oh my gosh, you need some of that, you know, stuff that takes the pain away from the muscles.
You know, it's funny because, you know, I wake up in the morning. And like 2 days ago, I couldn't even move my arms. I couldn't even stand it. You know what? With the prophetic word of King Clemens, I want you to extend your arms. I was like, how can I extend my arms, my Lord? I can barely move them.
Oh my gosh, like, that's hilarious.
Oh my goodness.
The things we do.
I couldn't even fold them. I'm serious. I was holding my both arms. So I was like.
Oh Lord, you're funny. Okay, well, there you go. Moderation, guys, moderation.
Yes, moderation, exactly. So let me just read your prophetic word, shall we?
Okay, yeah, right. I got that this afternoon.
Right? Okay, I'm going to read the prophetic word. Voy a leer la palabra profética de la pastora. ¿Cómo se dice? Epiphany, I think. Yo creo que se dice epifanía, ¿no? A ver, para aquí los que saben mejor inglés y español, digo, los que saben mejor español, ¿cómo se dice epiphany en español? ¿Se dice epifanía? Por favor, dígame ahí, porque así no quiero sonar como un completo idiota. All right, so let me read it in English first. It says, the epiphany is coming. The paradox continues. The weak shall be strong, the poor shall be rich. Oh my God. That's the collapse, that's the financial collapse.
There you go.
Okay, epifania. Okay, epifania. All right. So the weak shall be strong, the poor shall be rich. The humble shall be exalted, and the unworthy shall be made worthy. Oh my God. Listen to the new sound that I'm sending across the nations of the world. Listen to the heartbeat of my creation. As my power rises and as mankind battles for supremacy, my voice rises all about to declare freedom. You know, that little part right there is beautiful. Because that's exactly what's happening right now. I'm going to talk about the war and then how the elite is pushing for the World War III and what they do, and it's because of supremacy.
Amen.
You know, so that's true.
Mm-hmm.
I declare freedom from sin, freedom from sickness, freedom from poverty, freedom for despair, from despair. Yes, as darkness rises and seeks to divide and conquer, my power rises above all like a tsunami of peace and joy and love, overtaking the hearts and lives of the people and bringing an inward revolution to an outward dilemma. So shout, for my kingdom is rising. So dance, for my grace is abounding. So sing of my glorious victory. Listen to the sounds of the trumpets as they blow across the land. Listen to the voice of triumph, triumph as it rises above the deep. Understanding and deliverance is being released. Be assured that no rock will be left unturned, for I am the Lord God Almighty. My host has been released and come with great force and skill. Now posture yourself, behold the hand of your God who overtakes the sin of the world and defies the plans of the enemy. For I arise now and I'm taking back, take back mode, and I'm rising now to take back what the enemies of God have stolen. Yes, I'm arising in your midst, and it will be a glorious day. I shall rise from the east and a hallelujah from the west. Do you not see, do you not perceive what I've been saying and what I'm doing? Many will fall, but my army will rise as she has never risen before. Come out of the shadows. Come out of the caves. That sounds like the faceless army. It is time to rise up in my voice, my hands and my feet, so my glory can be seen by all. Do not hold back. Let the declarations arise to a new level. Let my praises arise. Turn up the volume for all to hear. It is glorious day. Do not worry about the enemy's stance. I am moving and shaking, quaking and stirring. My explosions of power can be seen throughout the earth. Enter in, run into me, jump into my presence, run on my highway of holiness, jump into my river of joy. I stand with my people in full array. Let the paradox come forth. And you know, this is a part right here that God told me about metrics. Yes, God told me last night about metrics. As a matter of fact, I wanted to call my show the new metrics. And you're talking about the paradox. And the paradigms in the metrics is basically the new paradigm.
Wow.
Let dark become light and evil become good. It is time to change the trajectory. Let the new season begin. Let the epiphany come forth. This is my day. This is my hour. No wonder he want me to be out. This is my day. This is my hour. This is my day. This is my hour, says the Lord of hosts. As you can see what he said, that let the paradox come forth. That's the new paradigm.
Yes, amen.
That's the new paradigm come forth. So that's why God told me, go live now. And I was like, why? Don't you see I'm hurting? I'm dying here. Go live.
Just sit and don't move. Oh my goodness. You know, one of the things that really stuck out to me about this was the fact that he's releasing the hosts of heaven. The hosts of heaven are like the angel that you had come to you the other night. They are the angelic fighting forces. And sometimes we look at what's happening in the world and we forget that God has an army.
Yep.
And his army is not from this world. It's an army of angelic forces. And the angelic forces far outweigh the demonic forces. Because the demonic forces were angels. A third of the angels left, or were, sure, I shouldn't say left, but they were kicked out of God's kingdom. It's all in the Old Testament, the whole story, how they were kicked out because of the rebellion. And but we have to remember, you know, we far outnumber anything that Satan is doing. And so sometimes we look and we are scared of the enemy. And I know you have to translate, so I'll let you translate. But we need to understand what God is doing, right? This is what he's saying.
Yep.
Do you want to talk Spanish now?
Yes, I do. Sí, señora, sí. All right, so.
Oh, my God.
All right, vamos a decir esto en español ahora. Vamos a leer la palabra profética de la pastora Karin. Y dice de esta manera, así que por favor ponga atención, hermanos y hermanas. All right, so la palabra dice, la epifanía está por venir. La paradoja continúa, el débil será fuerte, los pobres serán ricos, los humildes serán exaltados y los indignados serán dignos. Esta es una mala traducción. Indignados. Hasta con yo, que soy un idiota con el español, yo sé que está mal acá. Los indignados. Ok. Serán dignos. Escucha el nuevo sonido que estoy enviando a través de las naciones del mundo. Escucha el latido del corazón de mi creación. A medida que mi poder se eleva a la humanidad, lucha por la supremacía. Mi voz se eleva por encima de todo para declarar la libertad. Declaro la libertad del pecado, la libertad de la enfermedad, la libertad de la pobreza, la libertad de la desesperación. Sí, a medida que la oscuridad aumenta y busca dividir y conquistar, mi poder se eleva sobre todo como un tsunami de paz, alegría y amor. Superando los corazones y las vidas de las personas y llevando una revolución interna a un dilema externo. Entonces grito, porque mi reino está en aumento. Entonces baila, porque mi gracia es abundante. Ah, vamos a poner baila. Ups. Baila con. Ok. Baila. Ok. Porque mi gracia es abundante. Entonces canta de mi gloriosa victoria. Escucha los sonidos de las trompetas mientras soplan sobre la tierra. Escucha la voz del triunfo mientras sube por encima de las profundidades. La comprensión y la liberación se están liberando. Ten la seguridad de que no se quitará ninguna roca, porque yo soy el Señor Dios Todopoderoso. Mis anfitriones han sido liberados y vienen con gran fuerza y habilidad. Ahora postúlate, no es postúlense. Ahora postúlense. Ah, está bien. Ahora postúlense. He aquí la mano de Dios que alcanza el pecado del mundo y profana los planes del enemigo, porque me levanto ahora. Fíjate bien cómo está hablando Dios. Y es lo que va a cambiar todo tu paradigma. Estoy en modo de recuperación. Me estoy levantando y ahora para recuperar lo que los enemigos de Dios han robado, sí estoy surgiendo en medio de ustedes y será un día glorioso. Un grito surgirá del este y aleluya del oeste. ¿No ves? ¿No percibes lo que estoy diciendo y lo que estoy haciendo? Muchos caerán, pero mi ejército se levantará como nunca. Antes se había levantado. Sal de las sombras, sal de las cuevas. Eso me suena a mí como el ejército de los sin rostro. Es hora de levantarse y será y ser mi voz, mis manos y mis pies, para que mi gloria pueda ser vista por todos. Y después que arreglo esto, sigo leyendo. ¿Ok? No tengas, no te contengas, deje que las declaras, deja que las declaraciones surjan, deja que las declaraciones surjan a un nivel, a un nuevo nivel. Deja que mis alabanzas surjan. Sube el volumen para que todos lo escuchen. Es un día glorioso. No te preocupes por la postura del enemigo. Me estoy moviendo y temblando y agitándome. No es así. Aquí estaría, me estoy moviendo y sacudiendo. Esta no es la buena, sacudiendo. Y sacudiéndome, y sacudiendo y agitando. Sacudiendo y agitando. Mis explosiones del poder se pueden ver en toda la tierra. Entra en mí. Aquí sería entra en mí. Perdones, porque es que esta es muy mala traducción de Google. Entra en mí. Corre hacia mí. Salta en mi presencia. Corre en mi camino de santidad. Salta en mi río de la alegría. Estoy de pie con mi gente en conjunto completo. Deja que surja la paradoja. Deja que la oscuridad se vuelva luz y el mal se vuelva bueno. Es hora de cambiar la trayectoria. Deja la nueva temporada que comience. Deja que la epifanía salga. Este es mi día. Este es mi hora. Este es mi día. Esta es mi hora, dice el Señor de los ejércitos. Amén. So,
amen.
Tell us what is epiphany.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Oh, you were asleep.
I didn't know you were.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I bother you?
Okay, you woke me up. No, just kidding.
Oh, okay. All right. Sorry.
No, I didn't know if he was speaking English or Spanish.
Oh,
anyway.
Yeah, I know my English is so bad, you know. I totally understand.
No, don't say that.
Yeah.
Okay, so an epiphany. Epiphany is actually a manifestation. The church knows the manifestation of Christ when he was born. That was an epiphany. But epiphany is actually when a manifestation, a sign, something incredible, something that God wants to show to mankind is what he's saying is going to take place. Now, we don't know what it is. And I want to encourage the people, we don't know if he's talking about the RV. I was talking to someone, actually it was Pastor Stephen, and I was saying to him, it's not necessarily talking about the RV. We're on a journey. And I think, the interesting thing that the Lord asked me to spend the whole day with him today. So I did. And we went walking and we were talking and everything. And he was saying that Benny is, he's taking the jets on my journey. Like, instead of, naming and claiming a date, we're on a journey together. So it's almost like every time we meet, what's next on the journey? What's next on the road that God is guiding us through? And actually, it's what's next as we are crossing over, because we are crossing over. We're in the crossover now. We're in it, right? And you're looking for the signposts. You're looking for the confirmations, you're looking for the changes that need to be made. And I believe truly that God is showing you those and guiding you to those. For me, he's speaking more by his voice. And so the same thing here, for instance, he's been speaking to me about paradoxes for about 2 weeks now. And I've been trying to bring it into your show, but God has not allowed it. And I said, okay, God, I'm just going to wait. And because there's so many paradoxes actually in the Word of God as well. For instance, the humble will be exalted. That's in the paradox. You have to be humble to be exalted. Whereas the world would say, push your way to the top. The Bible says the weak are strong, or that we're strong when we're weak. It actually says that we are strong when we are weak, because when we are weak, we need Jesus, right? And then it talks about, you know, how do you receive? Well, it's you give to receive, which is another paradox. Another paradox, hang on, let me turn my page here. Another paradox is, this is my favorite one, and I think we were kind of discussing this the other day, that in order to really have true life in Christ, we need to die. Right? And it's not our flesh that's dying, but our old man, our old self, our old way of living has to die, and then Christ rises up in us with a new power and a new authority. And then, you know, the Bible says you have to lose your life to find it. And so there's so many paradoxes, and God here is speaking to some of those paradoxes. And so we're seeing the paradoxes manifest in the natural, and we're going to see it more and more and more. And the RV is a paradox in the sense of, you know, the poor are going to become
everything that we're doing, we're waiting for, is a paradox.
Yeah, everything absolutely.
Is doing is a paradox. Is part of the new paradigm.
Yes, new paradigm. It is.
You know, when this is the thing is that people don't get it right. You know, you guys don't know how dramatically your life will change. Forget about, I'm going to be able to buy all the things I can. No, forget about that.
Amen. Yeah, amen. That. That's what I say.
It's going to shake your reality. Means that, okay, for some, it's going to be a blessing. But for some, you're going to be a curse.
Amen.
You know why?
You got it.
Because everybody will want a piece of you. Just imagine how you're surrounded. You're surrounded by your family, your cousins, your friends, and they find out that you're filthy rich. Guess what's going to happen? Do you really think it's going to be peace and holy and joy? Think again.
I've already went through that. Trust me. It's not again. Fun.
Think again. You're going to have to disappear.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay? And that is terrible. This is the reason why I keep telling everybody, shut up.
Mm-hmm.
Don't tell
mm-hmm.
anybody.
You're right.
You know, if you have to live for the next 3 years, in a humble way, without not showing that you got money, do it.
Do it.
And then
Amen.
Disappear. Mm-hmm. Do whatever you mm-hmm. have to do to start your life all over again. Okay? But then again, I'm not your daddy.
No, but you got wisdom there. And that's the one thing. We need the wisdom of God.
Yeah.
And that's the wisdom of God. I'm telling you. I know
it. Hablando con la pastora. Para hablar de la palabra paradoja, la paradoja. La paradoja es básicamente todo lo que tú estás esperando. Es una paradoja. Todo es una... Es el despertar. Es lo que viene de tu nuevo paradigma, tu nueva realidad. Y la gran mayoría de todos los que me están escuchando no saben absolutamente nada de qué le estoy hablando. No tienen ni idea cómo va a cambiar tu vida. Y a muchos de ustedes, todo este dinero que van a recibir va a ser una bendición, pero para otros va a ser una maldición. Sí va a ser una maldición, y no es una cosa que yo te estoy diciendo. Yo quiero que todos ustedes sean bendecidos. Pero para muchos va a ser una maldición debido a que el dinero atrae una reacción muy fea de la gente. Solamente imagínate toda la gente que tú tienes alrededor de tu familia o amigos, todos están necesitados de ayuda, todos están necesitados de dinero. Si tú crees que todo va a salir como dicen en las noticias o en las películas, vivieron y feliz para siempre, piénsalo otra vez porque eso no va a pasar. Si tú tienes que vivir por los siguientes 3 años como una persona humilde, hazlo. y después desaparece de la faz de la tierra. Tienes que empezar otra vida. No te van a dejar vivir. Todos van a querer agarrar un pedazo de ti, a las buenas o a las malas. Ahora, tú puedes hacer lo que tú quieras hacer porque yo no soy tu papi. ¿Ok? Pero ese es lo que viene. Así que si tú no estás preparado espiritualmente o emocionalmente, ya te jodiste. All right. You know, I use words in Spanish that are more dramatic than in English. If I will use it in English, trust me, I will get everybody on my case. But you know, it's like this, you know, if you want to help people, and if you don't, if you do.
Don't worry about it.
You know what I'm saying?
Don't worry.
I cannot please everybody. I just can't.
No, and you know what?
Please anybody.
That's not what Christ came to please everybody either.
Yeah, you know, I mean, listen, people appreciate boldness, but not all people.
Yeah, I know.
People are so sensitive. How dare you talking like that, Benny? And they die. And I was like, what did I say? I was just trying to help you out.
Yeah, but you know what? Mm-hmm. Listen to me. What happens is, because, for instance, for myself, right? Mm-hmm. I pray a lot. I'm in the Word. I work in a Christian atmosphere. I am in Christian meetings. A pastor in a Christian church. So I'm inundated in a world that's far from the aggressive business world. Now, I used to be in the business world, trust me, and I was different. And so what happens is your spirit gets sensitive. So some of these people have what I call a sensitive spirit. It's not bad. It's just the way it is. It's interesting that, you know, God told me he was going to toughen me up. And now I'm okay. My spirit doesn't react to you. It doesn't get, you know, I was way too sensitive. And that sensitivity, I had to kind of harden up when I went overseas because I was dealing with, you know, crazy people over there and people that are in darkness, right? So I had to start to watch some really crazy movies in order to toughen myself up a bit. So you're dealing with sensitivity, that's all. So you just have to, also there's a spirit of religion that you're dealing with. When you were talking earlier about those guys that are saying, you know, don't do this, it could be actually a demonic spirit. It's called a spirit of religion.
Yes,
it could be a very...
The religious dogma, you know. And,
religious...
That's one of the worst, I'm saying it openly, I don't care if you don't like it. I mean, for those who are listening to me, the worst trolls are the Christians.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Been driven by a spirit, a demonic spirit, to attack other Christians.
True, but they don't know it. It's exactly. So crazy. You know, they've gone to the letter of the word. Jesus dealt with those people too, right?
Yeah.
It's called, they went to the letter of the law. They're under the law instead of under grace. And, you know, Christ came to reach out to everybody. Yes, we change, but it takes time. I'm sorry. Like... I had to rebuke one of my classes because they were backbiting against one of the people in the classes, saying, "Oh, he's this, he's that, he's that." And I said, "Listen, guys, he's been a Christian for 1 year. Like, shame on you! Shame on you that you think a baby is going to be like a mature believer. It just doesn't work that way, even in real life, right?" And they have to give you some slack. Unfortunately, you're in the limelight, so you're going to have to take some of these, what's a polite way to say it?
Yeah.
That people with verbal diarrhea that are coming again.
Oh, I forgot about that. Verbal diarrhea. Oh, my God.
You love that word.
I love it. Diarrea verbal. Es lo que me encanta esa palabra. Ella se lo inventó. Diarrea verbal. Para la gente que habla pura basura. Habla demasiado y no dice nada, como si fuera cantinfla y pura basura. Diarrea verbal. Qué lindo eso. All right, so...
Anyway, yeah, so, you know, people should read this word, though, because there's, you need to go in it and decode it. There's things that God is asking us to do. Now, can I share something that I think is important for tonight?
Yes.
Okay. A few days ago, the Spirit of God spoke to me. In fact, I sent it to you, but this is when we were under the demonic attack with your mom, and you came under attack. Remember that night a few nights ago?
Yes, yes.
Anyway, so I just left it because you didn't need to deal with it. But I want the Jets to listen to me. That's, I believe this is the main reason why God brought you on tonight. And that is, we are transitioning out of the year of the Hebrew year 5778 into 5779. And the celebration or the transition of the new year begins on September the 9th at dusk, at the end of the day, and it finishes, Benny, on September the 11th at dusk. So we are heading towards this, and the Spirit of God has been on me because there's something significant shifting at this time. Now, what is shifting? I don't know, but I'm telling you, I think God is speaking through the epiphany, telling us that, see, something is coming. Heaven is coming down in a violent force to fight a battle to win it. And so he's asked me, and he has confirmed it multiple times in multiple ways, to go on a six-day fast. In fact, the most incredible thing happened about a week ago. I was chatting with one of your Jets. His name's Frank. And he said, Pastor Karen, he said, God has been speaking. He said, I don't know if this is God or whatever, but he said, he's been speaking to me about the Jets should go on a six-day fast. I almost passed out. Now, I told him something that had happened to me, which I cannot share publicly because the Lord told me no. But I'm telling you, he's calling a six-day fast. It starts this evening, and it finishes on the evening of the ninth, or dinner at the ninth. Now, it doesn't have to be a food fast. You can fast TV. You can fast sweets. You can fast media. You can fast, can't fast Benny's program. That, you know, that's not allowed. Anything. Like, I don't know who, you know, if a person drinks alcohol, fast alcohol. But it's called God's chosen fast. So whatever God tells you, it doesn't have to be hard. It can be one meal a day. It could be dessert, right? If you like to eat desserts, it could be desserts. I don't know. Each person should ask God if they feel to join in on this. I'm telling you, it's a breakthrough moment. There is a shift taking place. This word came as I started this fast. And I've not just started. Can you imagine what it's going to build up to on the last day? Now, it's 6 days. Remember, God labored for 6 days and he created the world. On the seventh day, he rested and he looked over creation and he said, it is good. It is good. And remember, we talked on Sunday, yesterday, about the goodness of God. God is releasing his goodness, God, which is his love, which is his prosperity, which is his glory, all those things. And so we, you know, there's something that we are transitioning into. Now, one of the things, once we get into the September 9th, that we are starting the new year, we are shifting over. Now, it's interesting, 9/11 is the finale of that shift into the new year, which I know for the American people and the Canadians too is very significant because of the battle that you were talking about, how the what happened at 9/11 and what was actually lost, which was the RV. So we're heading up to 9/11 again, right? So there's something incredible taking place, and I believe God is alerting us. And everyone who hears this, you don't have to. It's all choice. If God is telling you no or not, whatever, don't worry about it. But I'm telling you, it's a significant time. And I believe that it's not a hard thing to do. It's something that God will give a grace. It's called a corporate fast. When a corporate fast is called, I'm telling you, it is powerful. It shifts. It can shift a city. It can shift a nation. It can shift a family. There's families that God has shown me that are going to shift that are listening to you. God has been showing me specific things. You know what God said to me today?
Uh-huh.
Are you there?
Yes.
He said to me this. He said that there is a man that is listening to you. I don't know how old he is. God didn't tell me his age. But he is stuck in Satanism. Now, I don't know if it's the man you showed or someone else, but this is what the Lord said. The Lord said to me, they call him Michael, but Michael is not his real name.
Oh, my God.
I asked God, what is his real name? And what I heard was Sam or Samuel. But God said, he's inviting him out of the darkness and into the light, that he was dedicated to Satan as a very young child. And now God says he wants him to come out. He has a destiny with God. He is forgiven. He is, it's like I see Jesus, just like the picture you have here, reaching out to him. God says he will cut the ties and break the curses off. It's his invitation to come back. Actually, the Lord did say come back, so I don't understand what that meant. Maybe he had some, you know, dealings with Christians along the way and you know, actually tried to come out. But God said, this time you will come out and he will protect him. So I'm just speaking to that person I believe could be listening. I believe he is listening. And I'm saying, God, Jesus Christ himself is inviting you out. And he will not only pull you out, but he will protect you, he will deliver you, and he will break every curse and every bondage off your life. And so God is moving into the Jets. And this is what God said. God told me he was going to increase my burden. And it's a prayer burden for the people that are listening to you. I've been having visions of help coming to certain people and shifts coming, people getting set free from sickness and disease. And Benny, you're moving into a new paradigm yourself. Mm-hmm. There's something going to release on your people that is the supernatural power of God. God wants to heal and set people free. God wants to restore them and bring them into alignment and position so that when this comes through, they will be able to run the race with Jesus. Amen? Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You just shocked me, but I will talk to you later about that.
Okay.
Okay, I gotta tell you that. You just shocked me right now. But I'm gonna talk later about that with you.
Okay.
In private.
Okay.
Okay. this is what God is, you know what I mean? God doesn't never stop shocking me. Never, you know, God never stopped impressing me what he can do, what he can listen. I remember one time we were talking about God, about, you know, about stuff, and you told me, you know what, we got to be careful. Remember?
Yeah.
Because God is listening. God told me that.
He listens.
About the car, right? Remember the car?
Yeah.
And I was like, what?
I know, he knows everything.
I've been thinking about that today. I was thinking about that today. I was really thinking about that today, okay? You know, maybe this is what I deserve, you know, because I say the thing that I said. But no, but God knows. I didn't say it in a bad way, you know.
No. You were fine. You were fine.
Okay. So, guys.
He doesn't do that.
Yeah. So. I'm gonna show you something right now. We're gonna start the show. We're gonna start the intel.
Okay, great.
And just to let you know, that the things that I'm going to show you one more time is for you to wake up.
Amen.
You need to wake up because nobody up there is telling you that these things, only me, only the show, only Jesus is telling you, hey, you're going to be deceived. Watch your back. Don't trust people. Don't listen to gurus. Watch your back. Things are not going to be pretty. And I got to really, really make sure that you understand that point. Because whoever is telling you out there that everything's going to be fine, that don't worry, the banks are very responsible, la 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 la, they don't know crap. They're lying to you. These people have no connections. Let me just state this. These people, they have no connections to the banks. At the most, they have the teller connection. Or the manager of the branch, or the branch connection. The people who telling you about, you know, tier one, tier two, tier three, tier four, that they have deep sources in the banking industry, they're lying to you. They all lying to you. And the bankers, they laugh about you. They really laugh at you. They really crack their ass because they, when they watch these people telling you these things and you start praising the Lord, they're laughing about you. They are laughing about you because you are being deceived by a demonic spirit. I don't know how can I explain it one more time, that the whole reason about the financial collapse and the break in the system is the whole root of evil in the world. Money can move everything in this world. It can elect and buy presidents. It can elect and buy presidents. It can choose what you have not chosen. It can manipulate your currency. It can revalue and devalue. It can buy terrorists, eliminate humanity. It can do whatever they can do to make your life a living hell. So anybody who's telling you that they are in the white hats, and the white hats, you know, they're controlling the banking system. I just heard an idiot saying that. They're lying to you. It will get control in a way. It will eventually get control because, believe me, that's going to happen. But during the RB, during the exchange, during the wealth transfer, things are not going to be pretty. They're going to run away with your money. Are you listening? They are going to take your money and they're going to run away. If they be able to go to Mars, they will go to Mars. This is how evil acts in the world. So, I'm not your daddy. And most of you don't have an idea what I'm going to show you, but this is just a little example I was about to show the whole world. Watch. I don't know if you guys remember that I had a dream. I was in the middle of the New York in the street. I think I was in Manhattan, and I was on the street, and I was really scared. And on my left side, on my right side, there was bodies hanging, bodies, dead people hanging on the post, on the light post. And every single man and woman being hanged by the people. They all were bankers. Remember that, wow. When I said that? I don't know if some of you Remember that I said that I actually shared that dream in a show. And I was really, really scared. I was really, really scared. Okay? And I saw the bankers, the CEOs, the vice presidents. They all were hanged dead all the way to the street. There were hundreds or thousands of bankers. They were dead. And I don't know what God was showing me with that. But as we, if you remember, there was a time in this whole process that bankers were getting killed. Bankers were getting suicide. And they're going to start again. Watch and mark my words. We are going to see more news about bankers being killed and being suicide. They will kill themselves. Because they are about to collapse. They are about to get caught. So what I'm about to show you is just a little example of what I've been talking about for the last 5 years. Esto me lo mandó uno de ustedes. Yo ya lo había visto, pero se me olvidó mencionárselos. Todos los gurús te han dicho a ti de que nada va a pasar. Fíjate muy bien, todos los gurús te han dicho a ti que nada va a pasar. Y muchos dicen ser banqueros. Y nunca han puesto un pie en un banco más que solamente ir al teller, al cajero. No estoy diciendo que todos los banqueros son corruptos, pero los que están arriba sí lo son. No sé qué lo que tú no vas a entender, acaso por qué se tiene que dar el colapso financiero. La razón es porque la raíz de todo el mal en todo el planeta Tierra. El sistema financiero es corrupto. Ellos controlan todo. Controlan los armies, las fuerzas armadas. Controlan tu moneda, controlan las devaluaciones, controlan las revaluaciones, controlan la pobreza, controlan los presidentes que tú crees haber elegido, controlan las leyes que tú crees que haber votado. Ellos controlan todo mediante el dinero. Por eso Dios tiene que colapsar el sistema financiero para terminar el control de estos corruptos, de estos criminales. Lo que te voy a enseñar, tú tal vez ya lo hayas visto, pero es un pequeño ejemplo de lo que vengo hablando de los últimos 5 años. Lo voy a enseñar primero en inglés. So this is the guy, he is the CEO of the biggest bank in Puerto Rico. He stole $1 billion from the people of Puerto Rico. And then he declared Santander as insolvent bank. He declared himself broke. This is just a little example of what's coming, people. A little example of what's coming. This is an old news. It was on May 16. But it's a little example of what's coming. When you exchange, if you leave your money in these big banks, they're going to declare themselves insolvent. And there's nothing you can do about it. Nothing. Literally nothing. They can declare themselves broke, and that's it. There is no federal rule that can avoid them. There is no federal rule that, or federal law, or measures that can, you know, they can lead the government to find out if they're broke or not. There's nothing there. So while the gurus are telling you that there will be no problem at all, I keep killing their bullshit. And I'm telling you right now, you better do your shit together. You better really, really wash your back, because they're gonna get you. Watch. In an island, no bigger than, in an island, no bigger than the county of Orange County in Los Angeles. No bigger than that. This guy managed to steal $1 billion. That is so far what they have found out. The guy probably have more than that. So they have been doing this for a long, long time, and they're gonna keep doing it. And watch when we got the RB. Every single bank up there, they're gonna go for insolvency. And they will go and do the bail-in. And how will you take into court? You got nothing. How will you pay for court fees? You got nothing. How? You're screwed, right? Unless you have a strategy. Many are thinking, maybe I should buy insurance. You're not going to do it because you're going to end up paying most of your fees to the insurance and you're going to be losing a lot of money. So that can make no sense. So what God is telling you right now is stop sleeping. Stop thinking about fairy tales. Stop listening to gurus. God wants you to be blessed. God wants you to really last long with this money. He wants you to buy gold and silver. He wants you to be holding this money because he knows he has trust on you that you're going to help the poor, the lonely. Because that's his command, that's his wish. So, watch out. Esta noticia pasó en mayo 16, en español, y este señor, el banquero puertorriqueño Carlos García, antiguo directivo del Banco Santander en Puerto Rico, desvió $1,000 millones de un fondo para proyectos de agua y alcantarillado de transacciones financieras. Este solamente es un pequeño ejemplo de lo que vengo hablando por los últimos 5 años. Cuando tú vayas a cambiar y dejas tu dinero en estos grandes bancos, porque el Santander, tengo yo entendido que es el banco más grande de Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico tiene una dimensión no tan grande como el condado de Orange County, aquí en Los Ángeles. Y este hombre pudo robar más de $1,000 millones, que hasta ahorita se cree que es más. Nos ha puesto a todos ustedes en la pobreza. Porque cuando menos dinero hay afuera y ese está atacando toda la feria, ¿dónde hay los recursos para comprar y empezar negocios en Puerto Rico? No lo hay. Cuando tú vayas a cambiar, si tú dejas tu dinero en estos grandes bancos, se van a declarar insolventes. Cuando estos bancos se declaren insolventes, van a pedir un rescate interno. Se llama en inglés bail-in. Te van a quitar todo tu cambio. Todo lo que todos estos años tú quisiste y esperarte para que tú cambies tus dinares, hasta el Zimbabue, si tú lo quieres creer así. Va a significar nada. Te lo van a robar así. A menos que tú tengas una estrategia. Y la estrategia es sacar el dinero de estos grandes bancos y ponerlas en cooperativas. Y en bancos de otros países. En bancos, no sé, tú tienes que empezar a hacer las diligencias, las investigaciones y las preguntas. Yo no estoy para responderte esto. Yo ya tengo muchos problemas con darte la estrategia. ¿Ok? Para que veas. Si Dios me sacó aquí es para darte esto, para que dejes de creer en babosadas y estupideces. Sí, los banqueros que están en tu sucursal son gente decente, pero este señor no es una persona de un sucursal. Él es el presidente. Él es el dueño del banco, o el antiguo, o el que está ahorita. Cuando caiga todo el sistema financiero, todas estas cosas van a terminar porque van a salir nuevas leyes, nuevos términos, etcétera, etcétera, para controlar estos criminales. Pero por ahora, mira tu espalda, cuídala. ¿Ok? All right, so let me tell you the other thing I want to show you. Are you there, sister? Hello?
Sorry, yeah, I'm here. I muted myself.
I thought you fell asleep again.
No. No, I'm listening. I'm trying to learn Spanish.
Okay, okay, all right. So some of you sent me this news. Déjame hablarle ahorita. Some of you sent me this news, about Fulford confirms the takedown of the Cabal. Let me just tell you something, man. I think I mentioned this before about this guy. How can I describe this guy? How can I describe this guy?
Lord, give him wisdom.
All right, let me tell you something. The guy is a fan. Okay? The guy is a fan. He's a fan. He said that he has, you know, like, okay, let me just tell you something, okay? You know the gurus that saying that they have deep sources? The same thing with this guy.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay? The only difference is the gurus, they got nothing. This guy only has a little bit sources. Just a little bit. He doesn't have all the whole sources. And the reason is because he's still alive. He's still alive. The Cabal will never let anybody alive and talk all this bullcrap that he's talking about. Mm. All right? Everybody know where he lives. Everybody know what he looked like. So he is not a reliable source. The takedown of the Cabal, everybody knows it's about to land. Okay, it's about to end, but doesn't take a scientist to know it. It doesn't take somebody who has deep sources, so-called deep sources. He doesn't take that. It's a common sense. We are watching all these changes around the world. Okay, but let me give you an example, a very good example. Full War, he said about 2 or 3 months ago that. The whole thing was done, you know, the Rothschild family was going to get in prison and stuff. Nothing happened. It is not going to happen the way that he's saying. Okay, it's not going to happen the way he's saying. It's going to happen in a subliminal way. Watch what I'm talking about. In a subliminal way, that's what's going to happen. All right, so he's saying the global currency reset is supposed to set up before December 2018. I already said it in the beginning of this year. 2018 is the RB year. 2018 is the RB year. Reset? Maybe. We are expecting that we are seeing going to, right now. We are watching the reset. I'm telling you right now. We are watching the reset. Can we see it before December? I hope so. I really hope so. But nobody's guaranteeing. I'm not putting a guarantee on that, because this thing is too bigger, man. It's too big for everybody. It's too bigger for me. It's too big for you. If you only knew the complexity, what it takes to do the reset, you probably have a little respect for people who talks about this. But since you don't know nothing what's going on, then I'm telling you, I cannot provide you with more information because I'm in deep shit right now, and I'm saying it with a nice way. I'm telling you, you have no idea what's coming. You have no idea what's happening. Okay?
Yeah.
This is going to be a rude awakening. Watch what I'm telling you. It's going to be a rude awakening. Just take a look at the prophecy of God. Okay? He's awakening you. is telling you right now, all the people that have control on this are coming over here and I say, no, that's it, I'm done. Whenever God puts his finger in something, a lot of people go crazy. As I've said it many times, look what happened to Donald Trump when he won. Do you remember all those retards coming on YouTube crying, well, somebody fix this, somebody fix, you see that? That's what I'm talking about. That's exactly what's going to happen with the reset will happen. There will be chaos and panic in the street. There will be riots. People will get killed left and right because there's going to be a psychologically event. Everybody's going to go psycho. Really, I'm telling you the truth. Everybody's going to go psycho. When God tells you when things seems at the worst, you better be very, very scared. Very scared. Let me explain this in Spanish. Alguno de ustedes me mandó esta supuesta intel de este hombre que se llama Fulford. Y este hombre es un... La única diferencia entre este hombre y los gurús es que este sí tiene conexiones, pero no tiene las conexiones que tú crees que son bastante confiables. Él se ha equivocado miles de veces en su intel. Habla de que el currency reset y que la familia Rothschild va a quedar fuera y que el reset va a empezar antes de... del 2018 de diciembre. Así lo espero. Ahorita estamos viendo el reseteo. Con toda esta moneda de que estamos viendo, que yo estoy reportando con Colombia, Venezuela, Argentina. Todo eso es parte del reseteo. ¿Ok? Turquía, el lira, Europa. Pero espero que pase en diciembre. Ahora, el ARBI va a ser en el 2018. Eso te lo garantizo, porque eso ya fue firmado. Ese es parte del acuerdo de la élite. Por eso es que yo le dije a mi hermana de que si no pasaba esto, para finales de septiembre yo me iba. Y me iba porque esto se va a poner feo. Se va a poner muy feo. Y mucha gente va a ser como target, o sea, van a ir en contra de ellos. Porque cuando este hombre no lo han matado, porque él todo lo ven como un completo payaso. Fulford es completo payaso para élite. Hay una razón por cual yo me mantengo incógnito, es porque yo digo cosas que la élite no quiere saber, no quiere que tú sepas. ¿Ok? Ellos no quieren que tú sepas la información que yo te doy. Si tú tuvieras un poquito de respeto a la información que yo te doy y la complejidad que involucra todo el reseteo financiero y de las monedas, tal vez te dejarías tú de criticarme tan fuerte. Porque esto es demasiado complejo. Es muy grande para mí y para ti. No te puedo dar más información porque ya estoy metido en problemas. Solamente por darte la clave de que no te quiten tu dinero de tu cambio de divisas. Así que no te puedo dar más información. Muchos de ustedes se me acercan y me dicen, ¿cómo está el RBI? ¿Cómo está la información? Yo no doy información privada. No doy información privada. Ni por privado ni a nadie. Muchos de ustedes me conocen. Yo nunca he dado información privada. Así que déjate de estupideces y no me pidas que te diga cómo va el ARBI. O miras mi show o ya estuvo. Now, one thing that I forgot about is that there are some people in English and Spanish asking me about the ARBI. So what's going to happen? Like I said before, I don't like that question. I don't like that question. I do not provide intel in private. I don't provide intel in private to anybody. Right now, I'm with Pastor Kerry. Kerry?
Hi.
Have I give you private intel?
No, not lately.
There you go.
I have. No, and I, you know what, Benny? I don't even care. Like, who cares when it's coming?
This is the reason that a lot of people coming to me and say, so tell me, man, what you don't want to tell me, man? Hey, man, what do you want to tell me, man? That's the way you sound. You know, like a Cuban, like a, you know, like the, what do they call, what's the Scarface? Hey, man, what do you want to tell me, man? Like that. So, I don't provide private intel to anybody. Anybody, I don't care who it is. I got really close friends. Pastor McCrary, my pastor right here. I don't provide them intel. I keep it a personal.
And we don't ask either.
And we don't. And you don't ask. You no. Just are only giving you what you need, not what you want. I'm gonna repeat that again. I will only give you what you need, not what you want. Okay? I'm already in deep shit. I'm telling you. I'm already in deep shit because I already told you about the plan of the elite to go bankrupt and then Berlin. No guru out there is telling you that because they don't know nothing. And they probably don't even give a damn about you. Okay? I have heard some calls. Everybody saying the same thing. Oh, yes, you know, you're going to be exchanging like this. If you bring your humanitarian projects, you're going to pay you more. Yeah, don't worry about Benny. He's full of shit. Like that. I heard my name in there. Like that. I just watched some of these calls. They got 5,000, they got 10,000. And some of these people that are listening to those calls, they're coming back to me. Because, you know, some of you, and most of you, you are intel addicts. You have been addicted to intel. You've been addicted to many information out there, 95% wrong and false. So when somebody like me come over and tell you, no, that is not the way the bankers work. These people are telling you, the gurus that are telling you, the calls that are listening, they're telling you, oh, no, no, we do have deep sources in the bank. Benny is no banker. He was never even working in a bank. He doesn't know what he's talking about. And yet, when I go live, I show them wrong. I've proven one more time what I've been telling you. And I'm not the only one telling you this. Some of these channels on YouTube, they're telling you the same thing. From real bankers, from people who were really, really, really into brokers, into really tier 4, 5, 6, 7, because they only tell you about tier 4. There are up to 7 levels of banking. Did you know that? Yeah, there are up to 7 levels in banking. The other 5, 6, 7, the other 3 levels. Not one of your sources know about it. And when you find out about it, you're gonna remember, oh, I remember that Rita Benny told us that. I remember why. I just wonder. This is how people, you believe everything, guys. Yes, there's decent people. There are people. There are really good people in the banking industry. In the banking industry, I'm not telling you there is none. There are a lot of good people in the banking industry. Okay, but on the high level, very few, very very few. Most of them, when they're actually when find out that these are good people, they get rid of them. They kill them. Okay. So. If they can declare themselves broke and then get money from your taxes, trust me, they can do anything, man. They can do anything. And they don't care. All right? So let's go back to my Jesus. So now the other thing I want to show you is what I told you about Iran. We are going to have a scenario like this. Pay attention, please. We're going to have a scenario like this. Iran is going to attack Israel, or Israel is going to attack Iran. Either way, it's going to be chaos and panic. There will be war. We even might be pushed to go through a World War III. They're pushing the agenda right now because they're about to lose the control of the world. And the prophetic word of King Clement says, when things seems at the worst, that little part, it means chaos and panic. It means war. It means breakdown of the financial system. It means devaluations to 1,000 times. It means revaluations to 300 times. It means a lot of awakening. Chaos, panic. That's what's going to happen right before the RB. And when the RB happens, everybody's going to say the word that Jesus Christ told King Clement. The people will say, why? Why now? Because God is going to destroy them. God is going to manifest his power in a beautiful, powerful way. The epiphany of the power of God. This is in Spanish, so I'm going to have to say it in Spanish first. Israel advierte que podría atacar objetivos militares de Irán a Irak. De Irán en Irak. Fíjate bien. Me mandaron un intel de TNT, Tony, diciendo de que un grupo militar de los Estados Unidos ya llegó a Irak porque era como un acuerdo anterior que tenían que llegar los soldados a Irak. Otra gran mentira de TNT Tony. Los militares no están en Irak por el estúpido acuerdo inventado por este idiota. Los militares están en Irak para confrontarse con los misiles y la gente de Irán que están dentro del territorio de Irak. Cuando pase todo esto, va a haber una guerra entre Irán y Israel. Israel lo va a atacar o Irán lo va a atacar, pero esto va a ser caos y pánico. Están empujando por la guerra nuclear, la tercera guerra nuclear. Cuando pase todo este caos entre guerras de país en país, saldrá el Arbí. Y como lo sé yo, porque la palabra profética lo dice bien claramente, cuando las cosas parezcan de lo peor. Por eso yo siempre he creído que va a haber caos y pánico. Por eso es ahí nomás dice todo eso. Ahí dice caos y pánico cuando las cosas parezcan de lo peor. Cuando Dios te dice algo así, tú, tu madre, tu padre, tus hijos, todo el mundo va a tener miedo. Todos. Va a ser el gran despertar rudo. Porque si tú crees que esta gente va a quedarse con los brazos así cruzados y no va a hacer nada por evitar la gran transferencia de riquezas, estás completamente idiota e equivocado. Esto se va a poner feo. Now, let me say in English. In English, says it like this. Israel warns that it could attack Iran's military targets in Iraq. Before I continue with this news, let me tell you something. Somebody sent me a so-called intel from TNT Tony. He says that the military, there are American troops right now in Iraq that are right in Iraq due to an agreement before. Previous agreement. Hey, Tony, I know you're listening to my show. I wish you could at least get your stuff straight out and, you know, I wish you could at least get one intel or news correct. But even in something like this, you were wrong. The United States troops were not, are not in Iraq because of so-called, you know, guard the security of the nation or the people out there. No. The United States arrived, and the troops arrived to Iraq because they are going to confront the Iranians and their missiles that they have, that they are getting to launch and shoot to Israel. That is the reason why. And if a body will say, no, I don't want you guys to come over here, watch what I'm talking about. Watch what I'm saying. I'm not a psychic, but a body might come out and say, I want all those military from the United States out of Iraq right now. Watch. When that happens, Iraq is going to turn their back to the United States. I have always believed that these people are going to betray the United States. Always believe that. They're going to choose Iran, whether they like it or not. They already did. They are basically getting rid of the dollar, and they're trading with Iran. I might be completely wrong, but watch if it happens. There's a reason when the prophetic word says that the people will say, why now? Because things are not going to be pretty. So Israel, watch what I'm saying. Israel may attack Iran and destroy all those missiles that they know they're keeping in for them. Or Iran might start attacking Israel. Either way, they're pushing for a World War III. Turkey will be involved in this. Watch what I'm saying. Turkey will be involved in this. And when Turkey get involved, watch Israel use his nuclear arsenal. It was prophesied by three prophets after the death of Billy Graham. Three. And they all agreed that Israel was going to get attacked by his enemies in the Middle East. And Israel were going to use only one nuclear head and kill 1 million Muslims. So in the middle of the whole thing, we might even have DRB. And why do I believe that? Because the prophetic word says so. The people will say, why? Why now? I may be completely wrong. But look how I've been saying it like crazy, like a broken record. Things are not going to be pretty. Things are not going to be pretty. And look at this. When Israel tells you, we are going to watch you, watch, they are going to attack you. They don't ask anybody's permission. They do what they want to do. All right? Are you enjoying the show, sister?
I am, very much. Very, very much.
All right.
Very interesting.
We are going to go through these things out that is going to wake you up. And now I'm going to show you a video.
I'm going to show you a video. And I have to leave.
Yeah. Well, you saw the satanic book handle that some of your schools in the United States will be exposed.
Yeah.
That comes from a court, not a federal court, but, you know, a state court. And we believe that it's going to be debated. It's going to be being blacked by a federal judge. And that shows you that they want to target your kids. The establishment has been targeting your kids with pedophiles, with satanism, the same way Obama target your kids. Obama target your kids, believe it or not. Then nobody say anything. Nobody nobody accuse Obama to be a pervert. Nobody accuse Obama to be a satanist. Nobody accuse Obama to proclaim the kingdom of Satan. Nobody. Everybody just look and shut up. And they will say, oh, yeah, man, don't worry about it. They're little gay kids, man. What bad is going to be? He was the one who pushed the gay agenda in your schools, you retard. In your schools, the establishment is pushing this in your kids because the best way to destroy the culture, to destroy your spirit, is by targeting your kids. Mm-hmm. The best way to destroy the church of God is by targeting your kids. This is why many prophets up there, Louis Sharp, Mike Taylor, Lana Bowser, they have talked about it. They have talked about that God is warning us because they're targeting the children. The enemy and the demonic manifestation is targeting the kids. This is the reason why you see a lot of pedophiles all around. I just posted something about, what's his name, Steve Jobs. According to her daughter, his daughter, Steve Jobs used to force her daughter to watch porno movies of him and his stepmom, her stepmother, having sex. And then you think about it, why all these things are happening right now? Because it's a demonic spirit. And it will kill you and grab you into the things that you lack the least. Sex. Sex is one of the things that many of us have a struggle of it. I'm one of them. I was caught up in a situation that I was having sex with any woman of anything, any woman I wish I could have. Fornication was part of my life in the past, before I came to Jesus. I used to have women left and right, threesomes, you can call it whatever thing. I don't care if you don't like it or not to listen to this testimony. I'm telling you, Satan will always use something to control you or to keep you away from the truth. And the more closer I am with Jesus, the more women are coming to me. I told you not too long ago, with this woman sending me letters. Just today, when I was coming from the gym, guess how many women approached me? Because that's how Satan always works. He will grab your attention, and before you know it, you're screwed. This is why all these things are happening. Pedophiles, homosexuals, perverts, Bill Clinton watching Ariana Grande butts. Because it's a demonic manifestation, people. That's why. Estoy hablando de cómo el espíritu demoníaco quiere apoderarse de tu atención. Están saliendo las noticias de puros pedófilos, están saliendo las noticias de puros criminales sexuales y están enfocándose en tus niños. En los niños se están enfocando porque la mejor manera para matar la iglesia de Dios es poniendo a los niños en ese peligro de pedófilos, de satanismo. ¿Ya vieron ustedes la noticia? Pasaron la ley que aquí en los Estados Unidos ya los niños podrían básicamente tener acceso a esa información de satanismo. Porque lo que está pasando ahorita es una guerra. Es una guerra entre el bien y el mal. El show de ahora se llama Guerra y Paz. Y eso es lo que viene este mes. Por eso tú estás viendo la noticia. A nadie culpó a Obama. Obama a nadie lo tajó a él de maricón. Nadie lo tajó a él de perverso, nadie lo tajó a él de satanista. Y mire lo que hizo él. Él empujó la agenda gay a las escuelas para que los niños maricones y las niñas mariconas se pudieran tener su privacidad. Si eso no es satanista, para ti nada va a ser. Pero no. Ahora vemos a Bill Clinton mirándole la nalguita a la Ariana Grande. Y la gente se siente sorprendida. ¿Y por qué? Si todo el mundo sabe que es un cochino bastardo. Cuando uno se acerca más a Dios, el diablo sabe cómo controlarte, sabe cómo quitarte de en medio y sabe cómo alejarte de Dios. Yo viví esa vida. Yo viví una vida llena de sexo, llena de perversión, llena de fornicación. A mí se me daban y todavía se me dan mujeres para tener sexo. Ahora cuando venía del gimnasio de hacer ejercicio se me entregaron 3 mujeres. Pero porque el demonio siempre te va a estar atacando, siempre va a estar dándote esas tentaciones para sacarte del camino de Dios. Por eso es que es importante que tú tengas que despertar, porque esta es una guerra entre el mal y el bien. Es una guerra espiritual. Nuestros enemigos no tienen carne. Nuestros enemigos son espíritus. Espíritus satánicos. All right. So that's the reason why. That is the reason why I keep telling everybody, wake up. God want me to come over here and tell you one more time, wake up. Satan is around us. He's among us. He's attacking. He attacked me 2 days ago, and he will continue attacking until you give up. You give up your currency. You give up your hope. And yes, you give up Jesus. Because our real war is not against flesh and blood. It's against a spiritual demonic manifestation.
Amen.
Okay? That is the real war. And by the way, my show is called War and Peace. We already talked about the war. Now I want to tell you about the peace. There will be a moment that the war will be stopped. But since the manifestation of the demons and Lucifer and Satan are right now trying to prevent the world wealth transfer, Satan has a private and obscure and mysterious way to come out with a second plan. I'm not saying that it might happen, but it looks like it probably happened. If anybody's going to stop the war, it probably will be the Antichrist. I'm sorry. I may be totally wrong, but I still believe that that's going to happen. What do you think?
I don't know. You could be right. I don't know, but wow. I never thought about it.
Yep.
But it would be the perfect setup.
Yep. So, we got to be watch. You got to watch. Because, you know, there are people out there that want to make sure, the gurus, they want to make sure that you're living in Disneyland, in a fairy tale land. Disneyland is a fairy tale land. Yes, it is. Disneyland is a fairy land, fairy tale land. They believe in everything that you don't know if it is true or not. They believe in conspiracy stuff. They believe in the family dragon stuff. They believe in Saint Germain, they believe in the aliens, they believe in conspiracy stuff, and the white hats, and everything. Nobody knows exactly what the heck they're talking about, but they believe it. They do. I still have women and men talking to me, hey man, I heard that the white hats are doing, like, what the heck you talking about, man? Why you wanna waste my time? And they don't like it. They want me to follow their bullshit. They are serious. So don't waste my time. All right? If you cannot have a coherent conversation, please don't even bother me. I'm too busy. All right? So, vamos a hablar ahora del Intel. Este es tu Intel. Voy a decirlo en español ahorita porque voy a terminar el show. Voy a terminar el show con unas pequeñas palabras de la profetisa Princesa Bola. Pon mucha atención porque este es tu Intel, ¿ok? Se cree, debido a que hubo una firma entre la élite de Argentina y la élite nueva en salvar la economía de Argentina, porque este tipo era un títere de Illuminati, el Macri. Entonces, él acordó firmar el acuerdo con la nueva élite para salvar a esa nación. A propósito, esa nación es muy rica. Y ahora habló él nacionalmente, prometiendo que va a quitar la corrupción dentro de Argentina. Ese es parte del acuerdo. La élite nueva está enfocándose ahora en quitar la corrupción. Debido a eso, muchos banqueros van a perder la vida y otros banqueros se van a suicidar. Van a seguir sabiendo eso en las noticias y eso va a salir muy, muy pronto, ¿ok? Porque esto había pasado hace unos cuantos meses o el año pasado había pasado. Mirábamos esas noticias todos los días y los medios de comunicaciones se quedaban callados. Va a volver a pasar, ¿ok? Va a salir algo muy importante, fíjate bien. Vamos a empezar a escuchar de Irak las probabilidades que van a sacar sus denominaciones menores. Las bajas denominaciones. Es muy probable que hasta saquen la fotografía de las nuevas denominaciones que van a sacar a destruirlas a todo el mundo en Irak. Cuando eso pase, vuelvo a repetírtelo, los gurús te van a venir diciendo que ya los bancos te van a dar 1.800, que ya los grupos privados van a cambiar, la misma babosada, la misma estupidez de siempre, ¿ok? Pero eso viene ya en la siguiente semana o dos semanas, eso es lo que me han dicho a mí, mis fuentes, ¿ok? Entonces tuve que alejarme un poco porque ya quieren cerrar las puertas. Y la quieren cerrar porque no quieren que sepan el plan maestro. Ya te dije, yo hablé anteriormente que ellos tienen un plan maestro para hacer creer a todo el mundo que no va a haber Arbi. Pon mucha atención. Ellos tienen un plan maestro que tienen que te van a convencer que no va a haber cambio público, que no va a haber cambio para nada, ¿me entiendes? Entonces, esto es lo que yo logré tener de mis fuentes. Van a cerrar las puertas muy pronto y cuando las cierran las puertas, ni yo voy a poder saber nada, ni absolutamente nadie, porque como no todos los gurús no tienen ninguna comunicación, te están mintiendo, ellos no tienen nada, se van a inventar cosas. Entonces, este es tu Intel que tienes hoy. Te estoy advirtiendo, no llames a ningún número 1-800, ni tampoco te metas a grupos privados. ¿Ok? Espero volverte a ver mañana, si no es mañana, el miércoles. Espero que no sea el miércoles, porque el miércoles me van a volver a agarrar mi entrenador y creo que no voy a poder esta vez ni hablar. All right. This is your intel. Pay attention, please. I have knowledge that, Jesus Christ. All right. So I have knowledge that these people, the bankers, the new elite is going to start getting rid of corruption in the banking industry. You're going to find that about a lot of bankers getting killed. And also you're going to find that about a lot of bankers getting suicide. Okay? After that, you also will know that you're going to be starting hearing gurus telling you about the 800 number again. Okay? And that you're going to be exchanging, and then they're going to hear that private groups are going to be exchanging, or they're changing already. The same bullcrap that you heard before, okay? The same thing. The master plan that I told you that the elite had is to convince you that there will be no more RB. I told you about that. They are getting ready to implement that master plan. They're going to close the doors and nobody will be able to actually get any information from the elite. Not me, not anybody. Don't worry about the liars of the gurus. They don't have nothing. If I don't get anything, they got nothing. They're going to close the door and they're not going to give me more information. Why? Because you are about to exchange. Okay? You are about to exchange. But before that, they're going to push for war. And somebody's going to push for peace. I've been shocked today because what she said, somebody named, I'm not going to mention his name again. I will talk to Pastor Karen in private later on. If Mario is listening to my show, he's already shocked. If my other friends are listening to my show, they're already shocked. I can guarantee you that. So, it's incredible.
It's Jesus.
I know. So the elite, well, let me just tell you something. Since Argentina signed an agreement with the new elite, the agreement was that the Argentinian president supposed to get rid of corruption in his country. So he signed already, they're going to save his country, they're going to save his economy. The new markets are about to be released, something that I did not mention in Spanish. Let me explain in Spanish after that. The new markets are going to be reintroduced into the stock exchange. The new bonds are going to be introduced in the stock exchange. And there will be a lot of movements, a lot of currencies around the world will devalue, and they're going to start, after they start devaluing and everybody start going down, guess what's coming? Revaluations. Okay? So right now, we got rupiah devaluing, the biggest devaluations of history. We haven't heard anything about the dong. Watch what I'm talking about. We haven't heard anything about the dong. When it happens with the dong, watch, it's going to be the bomb. Okay? It's going to be the bomb. I've been saying it for 5 years. So get ready. Una de las cosas que no te mencioné fue de que van a empezar las devaluaciones. Muchas monedas alrededor del mundo se van a devaluar. Cuando pase eso, el siguiente paso es las revaluaciones. Cuando pase eso, prepárate. Ya vimos la rupia que se devaluó 3 veces. Y van a venir otras monedas que se van a revaluar 3 veces. No hemos oído nada del don. Cuando le pase el don, prepárate, porque el don va a ser la bomba. El don va a ser la bomba. Prepárate, te lo estoy advirtiendo. ¿Ok? Y ya viene esto. All right, so that was your intel, what I was able to give to you. I have more things to tell you, but I've been told not to give it to you. And I'm not going to give it to you. I'm only going to give you what you need, not what you want. Okay? And that's your intel. Not divine intel, but your intel. Okay? Lo que te acabo de dar es intel. No es intel divino, es intel. Así que vamos a ver muchas monedas devaluándose y otras monedas revaluándose. Cuando empezamos a ver las monedas revaluándose, prepárate, porque esto ya va a caer. All right, so I just got the breaking news right now. Maduro have opened his airport to facilitate the immigrants from Venezuela to return or to leave the country. This is an agreement that probably they signed with the new elite. Once again, it's a breaking news. The president of Venezuela has opened his airport because he already did not let anybody leave the country. Now he's letting the people to leave the country. And also to help the Venezuelan people to return to his country. So this is something big. Something is about to happen. This is the awakening. So wake up. Acaban de mandarme la última noticia que Maduro acaba de abrir los puentes aéreos para facilitar el retorno de emigrados venezolanos y también para salir. No sé si esto también es un acuerdo entre la nueva élite y Maduro, porque acaba de hacerlo con Argentina, pero esto es grande, ¿ok? Así que vamos a ver, esto va a cambiar tu paradigma, va a cambiar muchas cosas, vienen grandes, grandes noticias. All right, guys. So, let me just play Prophet Princess Bola and just a little bit of her prophecy. Just a little bit. And after that, I'm going to play my usual song of the night to end my show. Calm down. Don't fall for chaos and panic. Okay? Don't listen to gurus. Don't believe their bullcrap. Don't believe that you're going to change in 24 hours. Nobody's changing until my Lord is done. Until my Lord says so. Thank you so much for your attention. I leave you with Princess Bola and her prophetic word of September. Get ready for power, progress, prosperity. Get ready for power, progress, and prosperity. La voy a dejar con la profetisa Princesa Bola. Que te listes para el poder, el progreso y la prosperidad. Dios me lo bendiga a todo el mundo. Y nos vemos muy pronto. God bless you everybody. And I'll see you soon.
It is raining all over me. Yes, hallelujah. Karababa shikaraba skandakuria. I can feel it. Can you feel it? It's the latter rain. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Ride on Jesus. Give us more rain until we are wet, until we are soaked in the latter rain. Hallelujah. Until we are wet, until we are soaked in the latter rain. Praise the Lord, people of God. Praise, praise the Lord. The rains are here. The rains are here. Praise the Lord. God is good, and his mercies endure forever. This is Princess Bola Adewumi, author, pastor, prophet, teacher, apostle, kingdom preneur, kingdom coach. royalproclamations.com is where you find me, and I'm here with the prophetic word for September. My God, my God, my God, people of God, we are in the ember months. We refer to the, you know, September, October months, the last 4 months of the year, you know, as ember months. And so we're in the ember months, and for those of us on the Gregorian calendar, it is the ending of our, you know, year. For those on the Jewish calendar, it's the beginning of the new year, the year 5779. And honestly, people of God, oh my goodness, whether it's a ending for you, it's glorious endings. And if it's a beginning for you, like you observe the, you know, Jewish calendar, it is powerful beginnings. Honestly, this last couple of months of the year 2018 are gonna be off the charts. My God, my God, my God. The rains are here, people of God. The rains are here. You know, the rains are here. The duality I've been talking about, the prophetic duality, is also going to continue, though. It's going to be pronounced. It's going to be pronounced over the next 3 months, particularly in October, November. You know, it's going to be very bloody. We're going to see the two-edged sword. But I'll save that for, you know, next month. I'll save that for October. But as far as September is concerned, it is a month of divine advancement. That's what the Lord told me. The month of what? Divine announcement. The rains are here. The rains are here. The rains we've been believing God, the latter rain, the former rain, they are here. The rains that we have been waiting for are here. Praise God. And there will be three P's that are going to characterize this month. As the Lord was talking to me, and you know, about September, you know, advancement, the month of divine advancement, he said there are three P's that would characterize this month. Power. P1 is power. My God, my God, my God. The supernatural power of God is going to be in display. Progress. Yes, we're going to see a lot of advancement, a lot of acceleration, a lot of quantum leaps. And prosperity. My God, my God. We're going to see a lot of financial blessings. My God, my God, my God. So, you know, I will go into the word. You know that Princess Bola will be in the word. And the word that God gave me really is still the same word that we have been looking at for this season, for this prophetic season, which is our biblical spiritual authority, which is the book of 1 Kings, you know, with Elijah, because the Lord said these are the days of Elijah. And Joel chapter 2, you know, about the outpouring and all that. So those remain our two scriptures. There was an added one that I'll share down the road in a few seconds. But he also spoke to me from Isaiah 60. But I'll share that in a minute. But as far as outpouring and power is concerned, my God, like I said, my God, the outpouring of God's Spirit that really began a few months ago, but is going to intensify in this month of September and October, and even into the November, like I said, is going to intensify. Honestly, we're going to see Joel chapter 2, verse 28 in full manifestation. full manifestation over the next 3 months. So that means that there's going to be major, major revival, major, major spiritual awakening, you know, people returning to their first love, you know, a restoring of godly fear and reverence. I'm telling you, because God is really pouring down out his spirit. He's pouring out his spirit. The rain that I'm talking about is really a rain of his power and of his glory. And so we're going to see a rising of fiery firebrand Christians, you know, the emergence of those God's end time army, you know, is going to become very prominent. So we're going to see really major, I'm telling you, major